Hello students, as you know we were studying the modern theory of origin of life. There are two basic steps of this theory. The very first is chemogeny that we have studied in our previous lecture, and today we are going to discuss the second step of this modern theory, that is biogeny. Bio means living, geny means synthesis or formation. It means biogeny is the second step which involves formation of primitive life. The modern or chemosynthetic theory of origin of life is also known as materialistic theory of origin of life, and sometimes it is known as Oparin and Haldane theory of origin of life because it was proposed by Oparin and Haldane. As we discussed that this theory has two basic steps, that the first one is chemogeny, that is chemical evolution, and the second one is biogeny, that is biological evolution, or we can say the formation or origin of primitive life. Let us have a brief introduction about chemogeny. As we have already studied that in chemogeny, the various simple inorganic compounds like ammonia, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and methane, they reacted together in some primitive conditions in on primitive earth, and they formed simple organic compounds such as acetaldehyde, formic acids, carbohydrates, various types of amino acids, etc. These simple organic compounds, they further reacted to form some complex organic compounds such as various types of polysaccharides like starch, carbohydrate, glucose, other sugar compounds, including fat, nucleotides, nucleic acids and polypeptides. In this way, there was a mixture of various types of complex organic compounds. These complex organic compounds, they accumulated in water and they formed a kind of broth. Various types of intermolecular attractions, they formed the colloidal structure by these complex organic molecules. And this colloidal structure was named as coacervates by Oparin, and they were also named by microspheres by Fox. Later on, the coacervates, they formed a water shell on their surface. This water shell or water film, it acted as a membrane, just similar to biomembrane of our present day cells. And this film or membrane, it allowed absorption of more and more proteins and other compounds from the surrounding environment or surrounding medium. The surrounding medium was water, as these molecules, they aggregated in the water and formed a colloidal structure which we named as coacervates. This absorption of proteins and other compound resulted in the growth of coacervates. Later on, some natural selection was operated to select the coacervates having a power of growth and division. In this way, the selected coacervates, they undergo division, they increase their number either by binary fission or budding. In this way, the chemogeny was operated, which resulted into formation of a complex colloidal structure of various types of complex organic molecules that was named as coacervates or microsphere. Now the next step is biogeny or formation of primitive life. As we know, the enzymes are necessary for various physiological activity of cells. It means the enzymes, they might have developed before the origin of cells. As we have studied in chemogeny that there was formation of polypeptide or some kind of proteins. These polypeptide or protein molecules, they got surrounded by some other molecules and which resulted in the formation of cytoplasm. Now the enzyme, they catalyzed the various types of reactions. They combined the nitrogen bases with sugar and phosphate that resulted into formation of nucleotides. The nucleotides, they combine to form nucleic acids such as DNA and RNA. Later on, some kind of proteins, they got attached with nucleotides or nucleic acids, which resulted in the formation of a system that can reproduce just like the living cells. This attachment of proteins with nucleic acids resulted in the formation of nucleoproteins, which was marked the beginning of life, or we can say that was the important step in the origin of primitive life. Such nucleoprotein particles, they were similar to free living viruses and they were named as protovirus or free living genes. Due to self-duplicating properties, the nucleic acids, they were capable to perform heredity functions. Later on, a thin membrane was developed around the cytoplasm by the folding of monolayer of phospholipid to form a bilayer of phospholipid, which is just similar to membrane of present cells or present living organisms. In this way, the first cell arises in the same way as the cuscinets were formed on primitive water bodies. The first cell-like structure with division power was named as eubiont or protocells or precells. According to Oparin, these protobionts, they were originated about 3500 million years ago on primitive earth having primitive conditions or reducing conditions. The precells formed on primitive earth, they were similar to microbes, and according to Kleger, the prebiotic structure, they were bacteria-like, such as nitrosomas, which fixed ammonia to nitrate. According to some other scientists, the formed microbes, they were similar to mycoplasma, which later on gave rise to monerans and protista. As we know, the monera, they include the organisms which are without a well-defined nucleus, and they comes under prokaryotic category, and protista, they are with well-defined nucleus and they comes under eukaryotic category. The monera include prokaryotic bacteria and cyanobacteria, and the protista, they give rise to eukaryotes, which later on developed into protozoa, metazoa and metaphyta. In this way, there was formation of primitive life, that is coccinets, microsphere, precells or eubiont, and sometimes also known as protocells. What was happened, just the protein molecules, they behaved as enzymes. There was aggregation of some molecules around them, which resulted in the formation of cytoplasm. Later on, the enzymes, they resulted in the formation of nucleic acids. The nucleic acids combined with proteins to form nucleoproteins, which was the important step in the formation of primitive life. Later on, a thin bimembrane was developed by folding of phospholipid layer, and a prebiotic structure was formed. Now the question is, what are the experimental proof related to the theory of origin of life? So the answer is there are two types of experimental proof. The first one, they are the proof of formation of simple organic compounds, and the second, the proof of formation of complex organic compound. So now we are going to discuss the experimental proof of formation of simple organic compound. In 1953, Stanley Miller and Harold, they experimentally proved the formation of simple organic compound from simple inorganic compounds under reducing condition. What they did was very interesting. They simply exposed the methane, ammonia, hydrogen and water mixture to the electric spark between tungsten electrodes in a gaseous chamber having reducing conditions. Means they exposed the mixture to high electric voltage. The hydrogen, ammonia and methane, they were taken in a ratio of 2:1:2. The electric spark was generated at a voltage of 75,000, which resulted in approximate a temperature of 800 degrees Celsius. After several weeks, the content was passed through the condenser and their chemical composition was analyzed by chromatographic and colorimetric method. They found there was formation of some complex organic compounds like amino acids, fatty acids, lactic acids, formic acids, but there was no formation of purines and pyrimidines. They also reported some intermediate products such as aldehydes and hydrogen cyanide, that is HCN. The hydrogen cyanide was further irradiated to high temperature, and this was resulted in the formation of again complex organic compounds like various other types of amino acids. Also, there was formation of purines and pyrimidines. So, what they did was very simple, that they exposed the mixture of water, methane, ammonia, nitrogen to under reducing condition to high temperature, approximately 800 degrees Celsius, which resulted in the formation of amino acids, fatty acids, lactic acids, and formic acids. The intermediate products, they were also exposed to high temperature, which again resulted in the formation of amino acids, purines, and pyrimidines. Similarly, the another worker, that is Bahadur, he also obtained various types of amino acids by subjecting a mixture of ammonia, ferric chlorides, and paraformaldehyde to strong sunlight. He simply exposed the ammonia, ferric chlorides, and formaldehyde to strong sunlight, which resulted in the formation of amino acids. Similarly, Melvin and Kelvin, they also obtained 17 different types of amino acids and various types of sugar compounds when they heated a mixture of hydrogen, water, ammonia, and methane. In this way, they also obtained some simple type of organic compounds when they subjected the inorganic or simple inorganic compounds to some extreme temperature or some other condition. Now, the proof of formation of complex organic compound. There was an experiment performed by S.W. Fox in 1957. What he did, he simply subjected a mixture of amino acids to boiling point, that is 160 degree Celsius and then cooled the content. This resulted in polymerization of amino acids and formation of polypeptide chains or proteins. These polypeptide chains, they were named as thermal proteinoids, as they were formed under the effect of high temperature. That's why they were named as thermal proteinoids. Fox stated that these proteinoids formed in the similar way like the colloidal particles aggregated with water molecules on primitive earth, which were named as crustaceans or microspheres. The Fox also reported the formation of porphyrin nucleotides and some kind of ATPs from inorganic molecules and HCN. They also found the formation of nucleic acids when they heated a mixture of nucleotides and sulfate at 60 degrees Celsius. So in this way, they also obtained some kind of complex organic compound when they exposed the simple organic compound to high temperature or some other conditions. So what Fox did was simply the mixture of amino acid was boiled approximately at 160 degrees Celsius, which resulted in the polymerization of amino acids and there was formation of polypeptide chains. These polypeptide chains were named as thermal proteinoids, and the thermal proteinoids, they formed the colloidal aggregates with water, which is similar to the crustaceans or microspheres present on primitive Earth. Now some other evidences which were favoring the Oparin and Heldon theory, that the formation of simple organic compounds in reducing conditions as reported by Miller and co-workers. Similarly, there was formation of complex organic compounds which were reported by Fox. Some exobiologists also studied that the Jupiter and some other planets, they still have reducing atmospheric conditions which are similar to the conditions on primitive Earth. The rocks on Mars surface, they have been found to the similar to the rocks which were present on primitive Earth. Now the question is, what was the site of origin of life, or is there any role of water in origin of life? So we can say the water is the main site of origin of life because of some unique properties of water which we are going to study. The very first property of water is the water is liquid between 4 degree to 90 degrees Celsius, and life also exists at this range of temperature. Second, the water is very stable compound and it does not decompose easily, hence it provides a suitable medium for biological reactions or biochemical reactions. Third, water gives protection to the organism from the thermal shock and also inhibits quick change in temperature of surrounding environment. Also, water is a good source of oxygen and hydrogen ions for the living organism. Water is an excellent solvent because of its polarity and hydrogen bonding properties. The another is on freezing, water expands as we know. It becomes lighter and floats on the sheet of ice. Similar types of floating sheets of ice, they are found in Antarctic or Arctic region. These floating sheets, they keep the water below warm and protect the aquatic animals and plants. Due to this reason, the life can survive even below the temperature of 0 degrees Celsius at Antarctic or Arctic region. Neither the some non-reactive and dry chemicals, they also become reactive in presence of water. The proteins and nucleic acids, they take their three-dimensional structure in water. Similarly, in liquid, form, phospholipids form bilayer in water, which form the basic structure of cell membrane. The water also causes hydrolysis of complex organic compounds, hence act as splitter. Similarly, water complex molecules, they are linked by dehydration synthesis, so water also act as binder. In this way, we have studied that the water play a very significant or important role in origin of life and similarly in existence of life in present condition. Now the question is, what about life on some other planet? The branch of biology investigating the life on other planets is called exobiology. Various scientists are searching the life on other planets through their space program, and the main aim of these programs to understand the origin of life, to understand the basic step or process of origin of life. As we know, the primitive Earth and other planets, they have originated under similar conditions, so there is possibility that life might have originated on some other planets in the same way or same manner as the life has originated on Earth. But still, now we have no clear-cut evidences for the presence of life on other planets. Also, Moon has no life because there is no water or no gaseous atmosphere around the Moon. Similarly, some signs of life have been found on Mars, but till now we have not confirmed the presence of life on Mars. In this way, we have completed the modern theory of origin of life, that is the most accepted theory of origin of life in present time. We have discussed the two basic steps of this theory, and the chemogeny and biogeny. The chemogeny involves chemical reactions during the formation of life on primitive Earth having primitive conditions or reducing conditions, and the second step is biogeny, that is the formation of primitive life by a reaction of some complex organic molecules. They reacted together, they formed the colloidal structure named as conservates, and later on there was formation of enzymes. They catalyzed the formation of nucleic acids, they reacted with proteins to form nucleoproteins, and there was formation of primitive life. Then we have studied the experimental proof of formation of organic compounds. First, we have studied the experimental proof of formation of simple organic compound, in which we have studied the experiment performed by Miller and co-workers. And later on, we have studied the experiment performed by Fox to explain the origin of complex organic compounds. And similarly, we have studied the role of water or site of origin of life. Okay, now we are going to discuss various important questions regarding the theories of origin of life. The questions are important for exam point of view. The very first question is differentiate between cosmology and exobiology. As we know, cosmology is the study of origin of universe, and exobiology is the study of life on some other planets. The second question is, what do you mean by hot thin soup or prebiotic soup? It is nothing, just a mixture of complex organic compounds, or including simple organic compounds present in water. This mixture is known as hot thin soup. The third question is, what do you mean by primary atmosphere, as we have studied? The primitive atmosphere having reducing environmental conditions is known as primary atmosphere. And the temperature was very high, there was no radiation belts, environment was known, oxygen conditions were reducing. These all conditions, they form the primitive atmosphere or primary atmosphere. Now the next question is, what are panspermia? The seed or spore form of life which might have come from other origin, other planet, that seed or spore form of life is known as panspermia. The next question is, what are coserates and how they are formed? The coserates, just the colloidal particle formed by aggregation of complex organic compounds in water. They are simply formed by their aggregation in water and interaction of various molecules with each other in aquatic medium. The next question is, give a brief account on Miller experiment, as we have studied the Miller performed experiment to explain the formation of simple organic compounds. Next question, why is the water considered as site of origin of life, as we have studied various properties of life, due to which we can say that water is the main site of origin of life. The next question, describe the steps of chemogeny of modern theory of origin of life, as we have discussed in detail. The next one is, write a note on origin of life, we have already done. And the last one is, give an account on modern theory of origin of life. So you have to discuss the modern theory in detail, and the two basic steps, that is chemogeny and biogeny. Thank you.